Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We're going to have very, very critical geometry in the coming time frame. I will come to that in a minute. First, let's have a look what we had in the previous time frame. Here on the SSGI graph, we've magnitude 5.5 in larger earthquakes. We see the typical clustering, 3 and 2 earthquakes clustering on the fifth, peaking magnitude 6 on the southern East Pacific rise. And there has been some seismic increase there after the magnitude 7.4 earthquake occurred at the Drake Passage recently. We see signs of a stress redistribution, and that will eventually also affect Chile. On the 6th, we see two stronger earthquakes, 5.5 in Vanuatu and 5.8 again on the central East Pacific rise, like I said. Then we had this high lunar peak on the 8th, and we see two stronger earthquakes in the 5.6 magnitude range. And then we had this planetary geometry on the 9th and the 10th that I emphasized in the previous update. And we see a seismic response, 3 stronger earthquakes almost reaching magnitude 6, 5.8 northern Sumatra, that was a felt earthquake, and 5.9 in Vanuatu and 5.6 in China. We had a full moon yesterday converging with a lunar conjunction with Uranus. You see the area, the blue and the high green peak. And there could be some seismic response there later today, tomorrow, and it could reach magnitude 6. Now let's have a look at the next time frame from the 13th to the 22nd. And what you see here is a lot of red and purple peaks. That's not a good sign. These are solid lines, and that means conjunctions, and they are the most critical. It starts on the late on the 14th with Venus, Mercury, Uranus, critical planetary conjunction, converging with a lunar conjunction with Jupiter, almost, and also Mercury, Sun, Mars. And the combination of Venus, Mercury, Uranus, and Mercury, Sun, Mars, that's critical, that convergence. The last time we had a magnitude 7.8 or larger earthquake was more than 2 years ago in Turkey. And that happened just after planetary conjunctions converged with Mercury, Venus at the same time on the 4th and 5th of February. We have similar geometry here, but not with the full moon like on 4 or 5 February 2023. Then we see a convergence on the 16th, again with Mercury and Venus in two conjunctions, Sun, Mercury, Saturn, critical one, and Venus, Sun, Jupiter. And that's a really tight convergence that happens almost at the same time. And the Sun is involved, and that's why you see the high yellow peak as well, exceptional geometry. And then later on the 17th, again a peak, a convergence, Sun, Mercury, Neptune in particular, and a right angle, Venus, Mars, Uranus. Really critical planetary geometry. And then on the 19th, well, I should explain here on the 18th, we see some right angle geometry really clustering there that could be equally critical as on the 15th. Right angle geometry with Earth, Mercury, and Mars that could result in strong magnitude 6 earthquakes. And that follows on the right angle with Venus, Mars, Uranus, also right angle. And it all happens there on the 17th, 18th. This is a really critical convergence there. And then we have a convergence of lunar geometry on top of that on the 19th, late 18th, early 19th. And that involves Jupiter and Saturn in semi-right angle geometry, but it converges with a lunar conjunction with Mars. That is critical, and it could easily result in a higher 6 magnitude earthquake on the 20th, later on the 20th, thereabouts early 21st. And it also converges with Mars, Mercury, Saturn in a planetary conjunction. So all in all, from the 15th approximately to the 19th, we have a sequence of really critical, exceptional planetary geometry. And there can be really large seismic activity as a result. In the worst case scenario, it could go well over 8 magnitude in a worst case scenario. The actual seismic response depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. There has to be a larger fault section on the that has reached a critical amount of stress. And it's very well possible, because the last time we had a magnitude 7.8 or larger earthquake, that was in February 2023. And the last time we had a magnitude 8 or larger earthquake was in August 2021. That's almost 4 years ago. So this planetary geometry can very well trigger very large seismic activity. Be on extra alert, have an earthquake plan that can be life-saving. Then we have another right angle with Venus, Jupiter, Neptune coming up later on the 21st, just before another convergence of lunar geometry with Saturn and Neptune. And that could result in a seismic response around the 23rd. But keep in mind the sequence of planetary geometry. In the solar system, we see this. On the 15th, we have this convergence of Mercury, Sun, and Mars in a conjunction, Venus, Mercury, Uranus, and also a lunar conjunction with Jupiter. And that is a really tight convergence there. It's critical. Then we have a day later, Venus, Sun, Jupiter, critical conjunction there. That also happened before the 7.8 in Turkey 2 years ago. And it converges with Sun, Mercury, Saturn. Now keep in mind, we have two planetary conjunctions with Mercury and one with Venus, and all both involving the Sun. That's a critical convergence right there on the 16th. And then on the 17th, later on the 17th and 18th, we have the Earth in a conjunction with the Sun and Uranus. And at the same time, almost the same time, we have Sun, Mercury and Neptune in a conjunction. So this is exceptional. You don't see this very often. A sequence of critical planetary geometry, these clusters of conjunctions. If we look at atmospheric anomalies, I selected the strongest anomalies. This is with 3 millivolts or higher. And that's from the 3rd to the 7th. And that could indicate possible potential regions for larger seismic activity. In the Pacific, in the north, that indicates Alaska. And to the south, Tonga, Kermadec, and New Zealand. And then this is 4 millivolts. That's a really significant atmospheric anomaly. On the other side of the Earth, I marked south of Iceland, in particular North Africa, Algeria. Morocco had a 4.6 recently following that atmospheric anomaly over Africa and to the south of Africa. Again, this is 4 millivolts. This is very strong. Then we have 3.5 millivolts on the 3rd, also on the 3rd of May, marking the West Pacific regions. It could be Japan, Taiwan, maybe the Philippines, and to the south, Sumatra, Java. And on the other side, I marked regions over South America, in particular Chile, northern Chile, to the north, Colombia and Central America, maybe the Caribbean plate, Cuba. And then we had 3 millivolts on the 7th. That's the most recent atmospheric anomaly, marking regions over the Indian Ocean, Pakistan, Afghanistan to the north, and Hindu Kush region. And on the other side of the Earth, also noteworthy potential regions. Again, like I said, the East Pacific rise in the south of the Pacific, but also to the north, California, and again, Alaska. California could definitely be due, Alaska as well, but definitely California, in particular, Southern California. There is a region that is locked, or let's say there hasn't been large seismic activity for more than 200 years. And that's near Los Angeles. That is definitely a potential area. Check out the website and the latest updates in the social media. Maybe we're going to see some atmospheric anomalies that we will post, of course, on our website and social media. Be on extra alert, have an earthquake plan. There can be really large seismic activity. We could see 2 or 3 magnitude 7 earthquakes in the worst case scenario. In the worst case scenario, it could go over magnitude 8. That's really, really, really critical here. Again, 15, 16, and 17 May. These are the days where we have really critical planetary geometry and it can result in really large seismic activity. Stay safe. Until next time.